Now, Wynton, you're not only a renowned virtuoso on the trumpet, but in recent years, your acclamation is extending to composing, and you're being talked about in the same breath as Ellington and Jelly Roll Morton and Thelonious Monk. That's pretty heady company, huh? You're unlike any, as we talk here, you're unlike any musician I've ever met. You're obviously a heavy thinking creature. You're just not blind acceptance, and this is the way it's done, therefore I'll do it. You think things out, don't you?
Well, I've had to think things out because I've grown up in an era that's completely impoverished in terms of music. And I have to replenish for myself what's lacking in my generation, which is almost everything. You know, I'm in a type of position where if I don't have intensive intellectual activity, I won't be able to create an environment to nourish myself. I think my teacher, George Jansen, was from New York, and he studied with William Vacchiano, who was the teacher at Juilliard, and also was first trumpet in the New York Philharmonic for a long time. And he also taught John Longo, who was my first teacher, and also John Fernandez, who was the band instructor at Xavier University when I was in high school. He would always bring me these books from the New York Conference for brass scholarships, and he would always encourage me to learn how to play. So I was part of a whole network of musicians who were very serious about learning how to play, older men, and they influenced my thinking and made me understand the importance of practicing and made me realize the possibilities that existed. Well, I think after I got serious, because I started playing when I was six, so from the age of 6 to 12, I couldn't play, really. As a matter of fact, when I auditioned for my high school band, the band director looked at me and said, "Are you sure you're Ellis's son?" Because, I mean, we couldn't, you know, I was on such a low level. But after I started taking lessons and playing, then I advanced technically on my instrument very rapidly.
How much practicing did you do?
4 or 5 hours every day.
Every day?
Every day.
Now, nobody, I gather, had to force you to do that.
No, I wanted to learn how to play.
Is that a lonely business, standing in a room and practicing?
Yes, lonely.
Do you still have to do anything of that kind? I would not insult you by using the word practice.
Oh, man,
but
yeah.
Do you still work out on your instrument?
Yes, I still have to practice. And the higher up you go in terms of your understanding of the art form, the more you have to practice because it becomes harder and harder to develop. I like for stuff to sound good. I don't like for it to be raggedy. But I'm not going to kill myself if it's not good. But I don't set out to have something be raggedy or half done. I don't believe that. It's like that whole school and thought of jazz. I'm not from that school.